गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम टू ऑल बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ फिशरी साइंस इन ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ सेमिस्टर सेकंड पेपर नंबर थर्ड फ्रेश वाटर फिश कल्चर टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस पेपर थर्ड वी हैव स्टडिंग यूनिट फर्स्ट ड्यूरिंग लास्ट फ्यू पीरियड्स। During last period we have completed the important article, important aspects, that is the introduction and definitions of aquaculture, importance of aquaculture, objectives and scope of aquaculture. All these points, all these aspects we have completed during last few periods of this online lecture series of paper 3rd. Hope you have understood what is meant by aquaculture. Then which are the definitions of aquaculture, objectives of aquaculture, and how this aquaculture, these are to be tremendous scope in different sector, as well as this aquaculture, these are to be produced the aqua product and aqua fish. And due to this aqua product and aqua fish, today we can minimize the scarcity of food as well as it is to be useful to solve the problem of food. Now, after completion of this first point, we have proceed to the second important point, and in that point only we have seen the introductory studies, introduction only, not in detail. The second important point is the introduction to types of aquaculture. Introduction to types of aquaculture. Here only we have seen the just introductory ideas. Introductory ideas about the different types of aquaculture are in those medium, in those habitat aquaculture is to be done. Fish culture practices is to be done. These are different sectors or these are different types in which we have performed the aquaculture, we have performed the fish culture and increased the fish production. This introduction to types of aquaculture, it is to be related to all sectors, that may be fresh water, that may be marine water, or that may be brackish water. That's why it is the broader term and broader sense. This is the large aspect in our study. That is the introduction to types of aquaculture. In detail, one by one we have studied in different sector, in different papers. Here only we have seen the introductory ideas, only definitions and introduction related to the these aspects, related to these conditions. Yes? Then introduction to types of aquaculture. Introduction to types of aquaculture. Aquaculture practices, it is to be important. Introduction to types of aquaculture. Aquaculture practices are classified in several ways. Aquaculture practices are classified in several ways depending upon the different aspects and situations. Depending upon the different aspects and situations involved in the culture practice, aquaculture types, these are to be classified. Some major and important classifications are given below. Some major and important classification of aquaculture, these are to be given below based on the different factors involved in aquaculture. Means depending upon the different criteria, depending upon the different diversified criteria, this aquaculture, these are to be classified, classification is to be done. But in these classification, some most important and most major types of classification we have seen, we have studied in this. The first criteria or the first type of introduction to aquaculture, and that first type we have seen, that is culture based on types of water. Means the criteria is to be first depending upon in which water bodies aquaculture, in which water bodies aquatic animals should be cultured. Means depending upon the criteria, first culture based on types of water or on the basis of salinity. On the basis of salinity, on the basis of types of water. Aquaculture is to be classified on the basis of types of water. Aquaculture is to be classified into three types of aquaculture. Freshwater aquaculture, it is also called as inland water aquaculture. Second, marine water aquaculture, it is also called as saltwater aquaculture. And third is the brackish water aquaculture, or it is also called as, that is, saline water, or it is also simply delta water aquaculture. Means culture based around the types of quality of water, or culture based around the salinity of water. Whether the salinity is to be less, whether the salinity is to be medium, or salinity is to be more. Classification is to be classified into three types. First, that is freshwater aquaculture or freshwater fish farming. This freshwater aquaculture, freshwater farming is also called inland water fish culture. Inland water aquaculture, inland water fish culture. What is meant by inland water aquaculture? Or what is meant by freshwater aquaculture? When aquatic animals such as fish, aquatic animals such as crab, aquatic animals such as prawns, arthropods, mollusks, or other different animals, when these are to be cultured, these are to be grown, rearing and management of these aquatic animals, these are to be done in the freshwater medium. In the freshwater medium is to be such as rivers, such as tributaries, rivulets, reservoirs, lakes, ponds, tanks. In these various freshwater sources, when culture of aquatic animal, these are to be done, culture of aquatic animal, these are to be done, it is called as the freshwater aquaculture, freshwater farming. Or simply it is also called as inland water aquaculture. It is also called as inland water. Remember that it is also called as inland water. Inland water when in water, or in those water bodies salt content, salinity, these are to be less. Salt content, salinity, these are to be less below 15 part per thousand, or below 1.5%, below 1.5%, such water bodies, it is to be called as freshwater or inland water. Freshwater means not freshwater. ज्याला आपण मराठीत काय म्हणतो, गोडे पाणी. गोडे पाणी म्हणजे काय, साखर घालून गोड केलेलं नाही. गोडे पाणी म्हणजे काय, इन दोज वॉटर साल्ट कंटेंट, दीज आर टू बी लेस, इट इज टू बी मिनिमम. साल्ट कंटेंट, इट इज टू बी लेस ऑर मिनिमम इन दीज वॉटर बॉडीज. फेन ॲक्वॅटिक ॲनिमल, दीज आर टू बी कल्चर्ड. फेन ॲक्वॅटिक ॲनिमल, इट इज कॅन बी ग्रो, ऑर सिम्पली रिअरिंग अँड मॅनेजमेंट ऑफ ॲक्वॅटिक ॲनिमल्स इन सच फ्रेश वॉटर सोर्सेस such as small impoundments, ponds, lakes, rivers, reservoirs, tributaries. In these water sources, when culture is to be done, it is called as inland water culture, or inland water aquaculture. Inland water aquaculture. Remember that whole world's water, or this inland water, is the best and most important source for the water. And on this water, 95% world's population and world's biota. काय म्हणतो मी, लक्षात ठेवा. On this water, in which water? That is inland water or fresh water. 95% biota. जगातलं किंवा विश्वातले 95% जीवजंतू हे फक्त आणि फक्त कशावर जीवत आहेत किंवा जीवन जगतात, इन फ्रेश वॉटर ऑर इनलँड वॉटर. दॅट्स वाय this is the immense source, this is the main source for the aquatic life, for the biota on the earth planet. That's why this fresh water is most important source to survive life, to complete the life. And that's why this inland water or this fresh water is important, where salt content, where salinity is to be low. And when in such water bodies aquatic animal, it can be cultured, it can be grow, it is called as freshwater aquaculture. Farming of aquatic animals and plants in zero saline water, or in those waters salt content, these are to be less, it is to be minimum. and salinity range is to be how much? Just it is to be 1.5%. 1.5%, or it is to be 15 part per thousand. This is the symbol of 15 part. This is the symbol of 15 part per thousand. Percentage plus one extra dot. Extra dot, it is called as part per thousand. Salt content is to be, salinity is to be measured in part per thousand, and when salinity is to be 15 part per thousand, that water is to be below 15 part per thousand, that water is to be inland water, that water is the fresh water which is to be available in rivers, reservoirs, rivulets, ponds, lakes, tanks. In these sources, this water, these are to be, and world's maximum production, these are to be produced from the fresh water sources. It is the most important source, because world's maximum, all 95% population only depend upon the inland water or fresh water. Means for all activities, for survival, for drinking, for cooking, for irrigation, for bathing, for recreation, this water, these are to be important, these are to be most useful. And in this water, world's fish population, these are to be found. The in these world population, 42.5% fishes or aquatic animal, these are to be found in inland water or fresh water. That's why this inland water or fresh water farming is important, and depending on the cultures sites or the culture based on types of water, when fishes, aquatic animals, plants or other different animals, it can be cultured, it can be grown in fresh water medium or inland water sources, it is called as the freshwater aquaculture. Freshwater aquaculture. Then second, brackish water aquaculture or brackish water fish farming. Brackish water fish farming. What is meant by brackish water fish farming? It is to be, we have seen here. Yes. Brackish water fish farming. What is meant by brackish water? When aquatic animals, these are to be cultured. When these aquatic animals, it can be cultured in brackish water. It can be cultured in a mixed water, where mixture of sea water and fresh water, where salinity of low water saline and high water saline, it is to be mixed. And in this mixed salinity water, animals, these are to be cultured, organisms, these are to be cultured. It is called as the brackish water aquaculture, or it is called as the brackish water fish farming. What is meant by brackish water? What is meant by the brackish water fish farming or the brackish water aquaculture? Brackish water is neither fresh water nor marine water. Remember that. Where river, these are to be meets. Where river, these are to be meet to the sea or ocean. Meet to the sea or ocean. At the junction of river and sea, at the junction of river and sea, there is a mixture of saline water and fresh water. There is a mixture of saline water and fresh water, or the region where such mixing of fresh water and marine water is to be found, that area is called as brackish water. That area is called as estuarine area, or that area is called as delta area, where salinity is to be neither more, salinity is to be neither less. Means salinity jasti asat nahi, salinity kami asat nahi, but in between salinity range is to be how much? The salinity range is to be in between 1.5% to 3.1%. In between 3.1%, means salinity range is to be in between 15 to 30 part per thousand ppm, part per thousand, or ppt, mixture, where brackish water is a mixture of salt water, sea water or marine water and fresh water, with a salinity less than 3 ppt, that water is called as brackish water. All estuaries, berries in coastal regions, brackish water, ponds, then zeals of deltic region, creeks and mangroves, waterways are the nature of brackish water. Remember that these brackish water and fresh water, these are to be different. because fresh water where salinity these are to be less, it is to be minimum. And fishes, these are to be cultured in this fresh water. These fishes are the major carps, exotic carps, catfishes and other varieties of the different fishes. Which are these major carps? Katla, Rohu, Mrigal, these are the major carps. Exotic carp, Cyprinus carpio, silver carp, grass carp, these are the exotic carp. And other catfishes such as Channa morellus, such as Clarius batrachus, such as Valiaguatu, such as Mr. Singala, such as Cavasius, such as Ompac bimaculatus, such as the Rita Rita, all these are the other catfishes. Means in fresh water, major carps, exotic carps and catfishes, these are to be cultured. Whereas in brackish water, where mixture of fresh water and marine water which is to be occur, where is a mixed water, these are to be found. And among these mixed water, over than 25 species of commercially important fishes, crabs, shrimps and mollusks, these are to be found and these are to be cultured in the brackish water. Which are these species from fishes? Let's calcarifer. It is called as Cebas or Mugil persia, Mugil cephalus, Mugil carsula, Hilsa ilisha. These are the species. That is, let's calcarifer or it is called as Cebas, Mugil persia, Mugil carsula, Mugil cephalus, Hilsa ilisha. Then Lisa species, Channos channos, Etroplus strancis. Then Opsurocerus species, Pineus indicus, Pineus monodon, Pineus indicus, Pineus monodon, Pineus venami, Scala. Then Perna viridis, Perna mytilus. Then Octopus, Loligo, Sepia. All these different varieties of mollusk, different varieties of crabs, that is Scala seriata, mud crab, Scala seriata, mud crab. These crabs, means mollusk, crabs, shrimps, prawns and fishes, all these are to be cultured, these are to be grown in a mixed water where salinity is to be in between 15 part to 30 part per thousand or in between 1.5 to 3.1%. In such salinity range, when fishes these are to be cultured, when fishes these are to be grown, or rearing and management of aquatic animals in such mixed water, it is called as the brackish water. And remember that in India, the sources of brackish water, these are to be tremendous, these are to be more. As compared to the sources which is to be available, or the available water sources, these are to be found on worlds, as well as in India. In India, tremendous sources, these are to be available, and that source is the marine water. Next to the marine water, that is the fresh water, more than 37,000 chaurus kilometer water, these are to be carried annually from fresh water. Then more than 2 million hectare water, these are to be sources carried from the brackish water or the estuarine water. And as compared to these fresh water and marine water sources, these are to be tremendous, because to the Indian coastal region from three sides, from west, south and east, in these three sides more than 8,000 kilometer square area, these are to be covered by coastal belts or the, that is the seabed. Hence these sources, these are to be tremendous, these are to be most important. Then third type is the marine water aquaculture or the mariculture. Name itself, it is the important mariculture or marine water aquaculture. When culture of aquatic animals and plants in marine water, or it is to be called as the marine water fish farming, or it is called as mariculture, or simply fin culture of aquatic animal, or rearing and management of aquatic animal in marine water in salt water medium. In salt water medium or seas and oceans, it is to be called as mariculture. It is to be called as mariculture. In mariculture, rearing of commercially important fishes and shellfishes are done in open sea by installing floating cages, pens, raceway culture, cage culture, or the different types of cultures. These are to be called as marine water fish culture or mariculture. In this mariculture, pen culture, raceway culture, rack culture, raft culture, rope culture, pole culture, long lines and hooks, these are to be used to culture of mussels, to culture of pearls, culture of pearl oyster, edible oyster, to culture of seaweeds, and also widely cultured with the help of net webbings or webbings. All these different aquatic animals, that may be fish, that may be prawns, that may be crabs, that may be arthropod, that may be mollusk, all these animals, these are to be cultured. In this medium, it is called as mariculture. And remember that world's 52.8% fish species, fish species or the aquatic animal species, it can be cultured, it can be found in marine water, sea water, or ocean water. Why it is called as marine water, sea water, or ocean water? When salinity range is to be more than 30 part per thousand or 3.0%, then that water is called as marine water, that water is called as salt water. Jehwa paanyachi kshaarta hai 3.1 kiwa 3.0 kiwa 30 part per thousand yacha pude asti, that water is called as marine water, that water is called as sea water, and such water is to be unfit for consumption for human beings or other aquatic animals. This water is to be not used. Sea water, marine water, ocean water, samudratla pani, sagratla pani apan use karat nahi. This water is to be wastage water, not used for drinking, not used for irrigation, not used for bathing, cooking, recreation, sport, or for the hydroelectric power generation. Means that water, these are to be not used. And in worlds to the India, in three sides from east, south and west. In east, Bay of Bengal, these are to present. In south, Indian Ocean, these are to present. And in west, Arabian Sea. Means to these Indian three sides, more than 8,000 kilometer coastal belt, these are to be covered. And this coastal belt, these are to be protected. These seas and ocean, these are to be protected. The Indian region, Indian area. And it is the natural gift to India to protect these three sides. Only we are protecting one side, that is the north side, and it is to be more difficult due to the our neighboring countries. Continuously these are to be attacking. We do not secure our country from only one side. Imagine all these four sides, these are to be open. What happens? That's why this mariculture, marine water culture, these are to be done. And in India, in Indian coastal belts, Indian exclusive economic zone, EEZ, is to be covered near about 12 miles, and it is to be covered 2.02 million square area, which is to be covered by exclusive economic zone. And culture of aquatic animal in such marine water, sea water or ocean water, it is called as marine water aquaculture or mariculture. Then instead of this mariculture, the fourth is the important metahaline culture. Metahaline, in off seasons of salt manufacture, in off season, when season these are to be not found, in off seasons of salt manufacture, the salt pans are utilized for fish culture, culture of marine shrimps, culture of Artemia salina can be undertaken in these super saline salt pans area. Salinity more than 2000%. Salinity is to be more than 2000%. It is called as metahaline culture. Metahaline culture, in off seasons of salt manufacture, the salt pans are utilized for fish culture. Salt pans are utilized for fish culture. There is off season. No salt preparation, these are to be occur. At that time, in this such salt pans, fishes, especially shrimps, Artemia salina, these are to be cultured to these super saline salt area. It is called as the metahaline culture, where salinity is to be more than 2000%. The nauplia of Artemisia serve as a protein-rich live food for the finfish and shellfish. Why this Artemisia salina is to be cultured? This artificial salina, these are to be cultured because the nauplia of these Artemisia salina serve as a protein-rich live food for finfish and shellfish, and that's why these are to be cultured on large scale. The dormant cyst of Artemisia formed under favorable condition also can earn good foreign exchange. The dormant cyst of Artemisia, when these are to be formed, when these are to be cultured under unfavorable condition, also earn good foreign exchange, and that's why this metahaline culture is also another important source. And all these are the depending upon the quality of water. All these three sources are the depending upon the quality of water. First, inland water, it is called as fresh water. Second, brackish water, it is also called as delta water or mixed water. Third, marine water, where salinity, these are to be tremendous, these are to be more. And fourth is the metahaline culture, or these are to be where salinity, these are to be tremendous, more than 200%, where without these Artemisia salina and without these marine shrimp, no other organism, these are to be survive, these are to be grow. That culture is called as the metahaline culture. And all these four are the quality depending upon the types of water. Hope you have understood. This is the first criteria based on the types of water. In next period, we have seen that. Thank you, all of you.